Today's video is going to be slightly different from maybe what you're used to from me. I very recently moved house, as I said also in a community post the other day. And this is the new house's bathroom. It's kind of a long story, how I moved or why I moved, what was my situation. I guess, you guys don't really maybe know much about me. I've never done a Q&A and stuff like that. If this is something that would be interesting to you, you can always let me know. I do post some ASMR vlogs on Patreon, which means like behind the scenes photos and, you know, some videos, stuff like that, but never much about my personal life. I do usually share on Instagram stories, for example, like nice buildings I see and stuff like that. But anyway, I did move and I am here. And obviously, I've been pressed with time. I didn't manage my time really well. And in between work and moving and the channel and the kitties and personal time off, I've had none of the last, and just trying to catch up with everything basically. So I decided today I could do a little maybe lo-fi, because I've got my Zoom, I don't have my Yeti here, get unready with me sort of. So I'll just use some creams, wipe my face, use like a cleanser, and then use a serum and a cream, and then in the end I'll brush my hair and put it in a braid for tomorrow's day for bed. Actually, I usually put it in a braid for bed so they don't get tangled. I'm gonna put the microphone somewhere there while I'm doing these things, obviously. I hope the sound will transfer good. And in any case, thank you for being here and for growing our community. And I don't know, I'm just really grateful for you guys and I'm very happy. And I hope you like the new bathroom. I'm sorry I look like a mess. I am tired. But I'm just gonna wipe my face clean and get ready for bed. And I'd love to take you with me. Okay, so I'm just going to start and take one of these little pads that are reusable that I have. I've used them before in some of my videos. And I'm gonna take this micellar water cleanser. And I'm just gonna use it on my face. And since I don't currently have any makeup on, just the remainings of what was, I'm just gonna go gently pull the face or the bare faces and the neck. Never forget the neck. And gently. It might seem rough, but I'm actually doing it very gently over my eyes to get any remaining mascara off that could have been there, and gently under the eye, this eye, and this eye. So now I'm going to leave this to the side because I'm just about to use it again. I'm going to take this. Cold coconut oil, I suppose. And then once you wrap it in your fingers, it just disappears. It becomes, it melts like butter. So I'm gonna use this around my eyes. Gently as well. Because I notice sometimes the mascara can be really, really, really hard to get off the skin and the eyes. And even when I've washed it off, I might wake up the next morning and still have like the panda eyes. So now what I will do is, I will take the other side of the little cloth I had, put some lemon water on it, and just wipe it away. I can already see it in the mirror that the difference is great. I feel like even though I just did this before, I still have mascara under my eyes. And now with the balm, I feel like it's completely gone. You should of course keep in mind the existence of dark circles under my eyes and the average lighting in this room. So, yeah, I can't even see without my glasses how that looks, how this video looks and how I look. I do feel quite exposed that I'm doing this it's on video, just my bare face like that, but yeah, maybe it's going to be a good confidence exercise for me. Well, depends if the people are nice. So now after I've cleared my face, the next step for my night routine is to use a 2% BHA liquid exfoliant. This one specifically is by Paula's Choice, and it's so mild. You know, when you hear the word exfoliant, you're sort of terrified of what that means. You don't want to chemically exfoliate your face, but it is just such a delicate like mixture, and this one specifically, but this one is extremely smooth. And I just put, I don't know if you can see, a few drops like on my cheek area and my forehead, and then I kind of like spread it out all over the face and let it absorb. And I've seen in a girl I follow online on Instagram, she's called Emma Oro or Oro, something like that. She's French English, and she's extremely into skincare, and dermatology, and she talks about these things all the time, and like the face and products and stuff like that. And that's basically how I got all my products, based on like the table she's made for like how old you are, what kind of skin type you have. It's just really good work. And the way I'd use my products, for example, the next one is going to be this, again, Clinique Moisture Surge. It's just a hydrating concentrate. And the thing about it is, her advice is to use products from thinner to thicker in texture. So for example, if you're like cleansing, and then you're starting your products routine, you'd first put something that's as clear as water. For example, for me that was the exfoliant. Then I would do something slightly thicker like this, which is the concentrate. And then if I had an oil in my ninth step, sometimes I do, I would do the oil next. And then lastly, I would do the eye cream and the moisturizer cream. And I always think the moisturizer cream is something that is like locking everything inside in place. Moisture Surge on, the concentrate, the serum, and I got it here on my neck. And on my forehead. And I can tell by how fast my skin is absorbing these products, how much it needed to be hydrated, and how much it needed to be taken care of. Which means for me personally, this translates to I haven't had enough water. Maybe I haven't had enough watery vegetables, and I definitely have not rested enough. These are all like, I feel like my skin is speaking to me sometimes, you know what I mean? I hope I don't sound too crazy. So, next for the second to last step of this routine, I have a different kind of eye cream usually, but today I'm going to be using this sample that I have. It's a Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Eye Cream. I have tried the Advanced Night Repair Serum and the cream, and I don't know, I find it incredible. Like honestly, if you're gonna save up on for anything and splurge on anything, if you take skincare seriously, of course, and it's something that interests you and works for you, because it might not work for you, I would 100% suggest that you take a few samples, try it for like a week if you can, and if you feel like it's going to work, then you should save up. I'm currently trying to save up. It's not cheap, but it's not, you know, like 200 euros, but of course, when you're talking about skincare and stuff, it might be other things that come first financially and priorities, you know. For example, my phone is still broken, my screen. Anyway, so I took some out and I'm going to dab it here on my face, around my eyes, I'm sorry, like this. And I think I have some still left. And I also put a little bit on my eyebrow. Arch there. Okay, then I do this in between my fingers and I just gently make sure I put it in all the creases of the eye and here over the eyebrow, and a gentle massage going from inwards outwards, maybe like tapping. this routine before I brush my hair and bid you goodnight. I've got a La Roche-Posay, the Cicaplast Balm B5. It's again a soothing, repairing balm. And I just use a little bit here. It's like the size of a pea, as they say. And again, I put some on my high points and my forehead, my nose, my chin, and always the neck. I never forget the neck as much as I can. And again, with the use of my fingers, I'm just going to spread it out in a gentle massaging movement. So I'm just gonna go like this, and away from the nose, and here in the chin, like this, and around this area on the lips, and gently down the neck. Gentle with the front, always put more pressure on the sides, never the front. And of course the forehead, I go out, out, and spread it out. I always like to think that I'm pulling my face like up and away, you know? Keeping it refreshed and vibrant. I'm not like dragging it down and making it upset in a way, if that makes sense again. Voila! That is it. Just a few steps, making sure I'm taking care of my skin and my face. And that's the same thing that I would do, for example, after a shower. I would try to lather some moisturizing cream on me. It's because the skin gets so neglected, but it really needs the attention sometimes. That's my humble opinion. And I can tell when I've neglected it, because it is not as, let's say, like I said, bright or vibrant, and my skin is harder, especially in winter months. Especially in winter months, these steps are very important for me. So now I'm gonna let this incredible, fantastic dew run down. And it's already parted here, so I'm gonna separate it in the middle. You see, sort of like my natural waves. And that is really fine, but by the time morning comes, if I don't put it in a braid, this is gonna be really, really rough. And I'll be full of knots, and we don't want that for healthy hair. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just brush it out. Always start from the edges, from the bottom. So then, if there's any hardness or any knots, be released easier. And there I go, this side is done. Significant difference, I would say. Okay. So then I will just step here to this side a little bit, and I will take this side. And again, start from the edges. Releasing any tiny knots or tangles in my hair. The hardest part is usually under, so like not here, but underneath. I don't know why. Maybe girls will understand this, and people with long hair in general. But I feel like if you have really long hair in under here, when you sleep or when you are in a cold, they all twist like that, and they can have such a hard knot, so hard to get out. But luckily, this time it wasn't extremely difficult, so no hard knots. For me, translates to no hard hair damage. So now that I've done both sides, I can sort of like reunite the hair, just smooth it together again, bring all the pieces together. I make sure there is no knots. I can totally hear that there isn't any. So the way that I am right now, I'm just gonna take very like widely and part my hair in three and lift the middle around like this. And I'm just going to start a very casual braid. Going in like this. I would like to thank you all for watching this video, and I'm really grateful that you're here, and I hope you enjoyed this night routine and it was relaxing enough to get you to start your own or just go to bed straight away if that's what you need. And I'm really excited to show you around a little bit more and for me to be doing this step and take you along. And thank you so much for being here. And I will show you in the next one.